Hey, Scanner Darkly. Can you hear me okay? Sweet. How are the music levels? Some bug reports in from the front lines. Castlevania, found this one. Get error messages if you load, try to play samples and there's no samples there. Who would have thunk? So, first step is reproduce Zbug. He said it worked once he got the waves in there, but I wonder. Just figure it out without reproducing it. Getting the same error that he was getting. So if I can't reproduce it, I am not gonna fix it. Keep this on the watch list, but so this one, there was a bug with the analysis page, but I think, yeah, that sorted itself out. These little lights here weren't showing up when you had highlighted cells, so that's all good. Scales maybe don't work on save load. So I just built the save load today, and there's always the possibility that I was saving the string of the scale instead of the key. This is supposed to be in Phrygian. So I don't mean scale key, I mean key value key. So this is where it loads. Yeah, that all looks right there. So that means that's probably so there's some setters that do other things. Most of the time it's okay to just directly update the values, but in this case you can see when we set a scale we're also updating the scale names with that, and then we're updating any notes if we're done initializing. So that's a simple fix. Yeah, no, looks good. So now when we so this says 8-tone something. When I load this, I expect it to say Phrygian. Or wait, I need to rerun first. Always messes me up going back to the Norms menu because it feels like you're exiting the script, but you're really not. It's just running in the background. So. This one yet. All right, semantic versioning and config and fm load. So I want to keep track of what version this is so that I can make intelligent decisions about it. I really don't want to parse the string for this. Where is it? One just yet, but you know. The save files to know which version it's loading, which version it's saving, and I also want this to be in my debug information. Cool scanner. Yeah, I had to do that the other day. It was pretty straightforward. It only took like 20 minutes. weak in the arcologies. Okay. So that's the first part about this. The second is looking into the load. First, let's start with save, I guess. This is the best way to do this, but this makes sense to me. It's a patch. Yeah. Here's where I'm checking the versions. I think I want a new function for this. I'm just going to return a boolean, and we're not going to change the version that we're importing, so don't need to load any of that actually. Got this new keyboard, and the page up and page down is right by where I'm used to having arrows. So, I mean, for now, this really doesn't need to do anything because there's no dependencies or other versions. So, yeah. That's not exactly true. So that's all we care about right now. developer, I do want to save Athens. I really like that. That's the first preset. So yeah, if any of you all want to see the Dockerinos, they're right here. So that's probably good enough for now. Yeah, I'm just gonna. I thought that was gonna be more complicated than it needed to be, so I'm just gonna simplify that. Oh, thanks, Dan. Yeah, I got a different setup going right now, so. Alright, the signal death rep bug. This is kind of the final boss of the night, I guess. I don't know. Well, halfway boss anyways. So what happens is when there's a row of, I wonder if I can just, so what happens is if you've got a if you're sending signals out, if you send signals to one edge of the grid, it would pick up on the next row a collision, which definitely has to do with an indexing problem. So my notes are, we have a hive on row N, signal dies at the east, so I'm going to the west. Start this. So hive sends signals to the east, and then so this hive, these signals are supposed to be just going off to the east, but they're wrapping around, and it's just graphically registering as a collision here. Actually, I wonder if it's not just graphically, I wonder if it's, actually connecting. So it might just be an optical thing, which is my theory. Yeah, no, it's not. So that means it's something to do with the animation to show signal deaths. So, well, it's either the animation or it's actually when we register it. Okay, so when I've got a kind of finicky bug that I need to reproduce, I set up a dev scene for it, which is what we're going to do here. So I go into config, I've got this dev mode flag, so that goes on. I'm going to set the scene, and then I'm going to build just like a little test case for this. So this is going to be scene 3. We want to select the cell at x is 1, y is 1, 2, 3, 4. And it's going to be a hive, and then we're going to open the eastern port, and then we're going to make another cell right below it, so that'll be at 1, 5, and that'll do it. save. Every time. Alright, so now we've got a nice way to test so we're not recreating that same scene over and over again every time. Change the tunes. It's one of my old albums. I recorded a video last night and I uploaded it to YouTube and then it got blocked because I had music playing that I did not own. So that was a lesson learned. More of my music. Alright. If the signal, no, it's got to be redraw, but to see for sure, make a little trail of signals. Okay, so we see that the X's are changing, but the Y's aren't. So that means the signal never actually goes to row 5, which is really good. That means it's just a display problem. Suspense. What will it say? 1-5. Yep, that's wrong. Should be 4-17. So that means that it's actually not the animation, it's the data coming into this function. So these aren't signals colliding, these are, well, actually I don't know that for sure. This is kind of a fun game, is to see how quickly can you cut out possibilities. Okay, yep, so the collision. Oh yeah, there's bound to be something in here. So so that means I'm not deleting the signals early enough. So they go out of bounds. They need to go away. Feels kind of lazy, but this also is pretty practical because what else would the index be? It's so index in this context is the location on the grid. So is it it goes from 1 to 128, so every single key has a unique index. Let me know if the music's too loud or too quiet. It's kind of loud for me. Well, let's see if that works. Dan, I'm using your rerun script. It's brilliant. Just actually having that a rerun function anyways. Just having that in here. Oh wait, no. I'm using your screen chat. But you showed me the rerun secret. Saves so much time. Okay, so that fixed the bug. So this register signal death method is to essentially we're registering it because we need to pass that off to the grid draw function so that they know that there was something that happened there, because there's a specific order that we redraw the grid. So the least important stuff gets drawn first, and then the most important stuff gets drawn last. So every time there's a redraw, we're gonna go down this line, and signal deaths are kind of low on that, but it's still, you know, certainly important. All right, real game. Where did I put those print statements? I usually I'll intentionally like put my print like with some dumb spacing like this so that it'll stand out better. If I was smart, I would like use Command F or something, but that's not fun. Alright, so that bug's fixed. That's good. I was pretty worried about that one, actually. Yeah, actually, this will be fun. This will be a good little exercise. So there's in-app docs, once again, inspired by Dan, cheat codes. So every cell has a little dock you can scroll down to. And now that I've finished writing all the docs, I'm going to put them in. There's no way to wrap text in with the screen calls and stuff. So I've got this really cute, very manual way of doing it. Basically, we got a docs table, and then there's these little tables inside where the line breaks are, which I just think is adorable. So here you can see this is like the homepage docs, and then this is how you do it. So I didn't want to be like, I don't know. My first thought was like write it like a normal sane person, and then it gets really insane because then you're like, okay, so then I'm calculating the width of the text and then dividing that and then string replacing and substringing, trying to build it. And it's like, no, dude, just do this. Just keep it simple. So we have docs for the... It says we have docs for Hive, but that doesn't exist in here yet. Why is that? I think I didn't get that far. Let's listen to something a little less apocalyptic. I know. Thank you. possible. Oh, yeah, no, that's very possible. To write docs as I go, because then when you're done with your project, you're done with your docs, and they're also like kind of like acceptance criteria. So stylistic call, all the docs are going to be lowercase to minimize preserve space. No punctuation, unless you need it for like URLs or something. Kind of pains me because we're uppercase everywhere, but I really don't want the docs to be like yelling at you. And then if I do capital letters but no punctuation, it looks sloppy. I really like proper grammar. 1, 2, 3, 4. Has any questions about anything? Happy to take a detour. This is kind of boring work right here. What's it telling you? What does it need? Not seeing it, not able to flash a new image. Could be a Windows thing. Yeah, it sure worked. Just right out of the gate for me. Yeah, I don't think that was like the one thing that I didn't have to Google a whole bunch for. a little ugly, but form over function for this. Yes, it is tedious, but I get satisfaction out of it. Some hopefully, I like to think of the musician that's in the throes of making something really cool, and something doesn't make sense, and they've almost got the thing, and then they just say they're about to, you know, throw the towel in, and then they see the docs and they scroll down, and then it clicks. You know, if that happens once, this is all worth it. Yeah, and we're halfway through. There's only 15 structures, so. Wait, domes don't route signals to open ports. Disconnect. Gonna have to press the white button. So I have no idea why this happens. I think it's my Wi-Fi. I've got Ethernet, USB stuff coming. I'm just writing little tables here. I'm not doing anything insane. And this happens probably once an hour. Sometimes I can salvage it from SSH, but SSH usually freezes too. Yeah, and teletype is definitely one of those things that help is required. I love teletype. Signals entering machine / analog shift register. Noun. Got more space to play with. So emit signals. Um, emit signals in like a hive. Emit signals. Signals like a hive, but based on this. I think these docs are probably going to most frequently serve to jog people's memories and not like tell you how to use it. Yeah, that's good. That's good enough. Good enough for metal. Alright. Oh, crypt. So this I seem to like post a link to the page, this one's too complicated. These are like harder than tweets. You don't get 120 characters, you get like 80 characters and less if they're wide letters. You get like 60. So how do you describe a rudimentary one-shot mono sampler that sources files matching the pattern, blah 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 blah, in two different directories, has DLC and routes the flow of signals from open ports, and you can change it on the fly via the parameters menu? You can't put waves in the dust crypt. Slashes are the worst. They take up like 5 pixels. They take up 7 if you count the recurring. Thank you. Oh, that's a good idea. Use a pipe instead of a slash. I kind of like that. Next level move would be like right up to the slash, and then change the font size, and then put a slash exactly there. And then, like, yeah, it's an awful idea. Isn't there some worlds where clones are acceptable? Pipe's like too thick, it's too medium, it's hard to read. Everything's one pixel, so you don't have that finesse that a pipe might have. Thanks, Scanner Darkly. Really appreciate you stopping by. Enjoy and good luck with the Etcher Chaos. Bad too, they take up a lot of space. thumbnails are fun. I made this. I don't know, there's like so much of the development of this has been just like setting up the guts of things. And then when it's time to like execute a feature, it usually just happens really fast. Like I think I coded the tunnel, which teleports signals around, in like 15 minutes because I had like all the framework set up. And it's like my favorite structure, and like just part of me that's sad that I didn't get more time. I didn't have to fight and wrestle with it and make it, you know, but I don't know, there's a lot of beauty in when it just works. Like this morning, I've been putting off the MIDI, all the crow, and all the saving because I was terrified of it. And I'm like, well, this thing's coming out soon, so I gotta start this. And I was able to do all four of those in like 3 hours this morning. And that's an attestation to how incredible the APIs are, I guess. They're not technically APIs, whatever. All the work that already went into the Crow object and the MIDI objects and the file system object and the table utility object. It's like I didn't have to do any of that lower level stuff. So, very pleasantly surprised. Very, very nice. Like Crow? Our Crow trait? So we have one trait that's going to tell us which pair we're going to. And then we have, 19 lines of code that convert notes to voltages, and that's it. I actually did have a note here. I saw this in, maybe someone knows, I saw this in Awake, and I just copied it because I didn't know what it meant. It seemed to work, but it's strange. Subtracting 60 from the MIDI note number before dividing it by 12, it just feels like some weird magic number thing, and I have no idea if this is actually the right thing to do. Played notes, I don't know if they're the right notes. That's it. Rocks are done. Nothing too bad. Yeah, I don't know. Let's see if I can figure out what this means. And I saw it again, and I think patchwork frequency. Oh, note number frequency. No. like, I guess, do I just need a table to see what voltages map to? I mean, how does that? I don't understand how this works yet, so this is fun, so we get to learn. Oh, there's that magic number again. What is 60? Oh no, the middle C argument. Oh no. Blast. So, oh yeah, it's all over the place. Look at those voltages. It's consistent. Well, not none of it, but. Oh, gosh. Okay, what's easy mode? Easy mode is just ignore the problem. I'm not gonna do that. So. So with MIDI, that note is just going out. Is, which sixty in whatever universe we're in is middle C. So why would we subtract 60 from... Yeah, I don't think I actually want to do that, because Arcology's scales all 128 notes from 0 to 127. But I don't think just dividing by 12 is good enough. 12. Yeah, I don't. This is just gonna stay on here. I'll ask someone about it. Even dividing by 12 doesn't make sense to me because. That's like out of the voltage range, so if you, and 127 is, it's just an arbitrary number, I don't get it, it doesn't make sense. Function use sweep, so this is more of a, just housekeeping activity. That's the other thing I want to do, actually. I want to make a little get ignored dev flag so that I don't have to keep toggling this on and off. I guess that's why. Look how beautifully minimal that is. Alas. Oh, how complicated do I want to get? Do I want to make a whole config override? Kind of do. Actually, that's a pretty smart way to do it. If I do say so myself. How do you check if a file exists? Stuff like this. I'm just gonna keep it esoteric and minimal. That's like a typo. I let aesthetics get too much in my way. This stuff. I just wonder if this needs the full absolute path. You know, computers do exactly what you tell them to do. Thank you. live config. Last time I broadcast. Sorry about that. That's silly. Lua, you do not type the file extension when you include it. Application configuration is going to be committed to Git, and then all my secret development stuff is Git ignored, and it's in a separate file. Because I promise you, if I didn't take that out, I would push dev mode true to the main branch, and y'all would see very strange things as a result of that. I care about this being hard-coded. Kind of a lot. Is that dependent? Underscore pen? Underscore world. Now, since we added that config file to our secret config file to gitignore, Git's not going to see it. We took out the dev mode stuff and then just added this little check to see if the file is there or not. And if it is, we're going to load it, and then that overrides. Actually, it doesn't even override, it just adds some more settings in here. So this whole config file is where all of the structures are configured. This is, or composed, so to speak. So if you wanted to give any structure any other attributes, you could come in here and just type them in, and it should just work. I think we're like close to releasing this thing. Yeah, that might be fine. It's another pull request to get this made in. Yeah, why not? Got a lot more done than I thought I was going to tonight. This crow note number mystery for later. Okay, function use sleep. Pretty much, I just wanted to make sure all of my functions are being called. Because I don't like having just dead code hanging out there. That definitely is. This one might not be actually. Yeah, if your grid's disconnected, you get this nice little screen. It's kind of fun. You plug the grid back in, it goes away. Yeah, I wanted to do some more work on randomizing and make it a little more intelligent, but this is fine. By more intelligent, I mean, like, if there's a shrine, make sure there's some way for signals to get to it. As it is right now, it's just totally random, so you kind of have to go somewhat high on your random seed threshold to make something musical, but pretty satisfied with the function method use sweep. I've tread over so much of this so many times. This dev file in here because like these debug things and like the scale thing and screenshot, some people might want to use that, and I might need it to help them debug something. Yeah, I made Ode to Joy on here. That was my scale test. Thank you. multiple notes. Should only be happening. This is just to make the indicator. Why don't things do that? So, out of all of the attributes, notes are there's notes don't, because of how notes work and notes are so important, it's an edge case, but it's also a core feature, paradoxically. So with the way the attributes work, there's actually 8 separate note attributes instead of like one notes and then, you know, that's a list or something or a table that you fill it with notes. There's actually 8 individual ones, which makes for a lot of really ugly duplicated code, but I'm not refactoring all of that. It was a decision I made a long time ago. So what's happening now is there has to be a recent change because chord speed should only show one note, not all eight. Exactly one, then we're building it up. So let's see what the note count's coming back as for these things. Quite ready to send this to Maiden. I need to do a little bit more testing, but I think that's gonna do it for this stream. So thanks for watching. This was a lot of fun. We knocked out like seven bugs. Yeah. Alright. So I'm signing off. Thanks for watching.